I grew up in Linwood Township, Minnesota. It was about 7 miles from a bank or a school or anything that resembled a town, I guess. Boy, we had a lot of fun though. There was a lot of kids our age in the neighborhood, and I have two younger brothers, but we're 18 months apart, so we're all like the same size. We did the typical country things, you know, in the wintertime we go snowmobiling, and in the summer building tree forts and things like that. But it really was a great place to grow up. Good people where I'm from, you know, everyone real friendly as far as helping people out in time of need. You know, I was just welcoming people in for dinner, that type of thing. I think that really stuck with me. When I was 3 years old, my parents put me in gymnastics. When you're three, you don't really do much more than roll around and try to do something that resembles gymnastics. And then when I was in high school, I really took it more seriously as far as competition. My junior and senior year, our team went to the state finals. I was a good tumbler, and I was real powerful on the vault, but not real graceful on the beam. You know, I mean, there's things I was really good at, and other things just pretty average. My dad has been a powerlifter for as long as I can remember, so he trained me for it. In a way, I think I may have just been interested in it because my dad is like my favorite person in the whole wide world. So we trained together in the gym, and then when I went to compete, I really didn't consider myself a competitive person, but he never pushed me like, you gotta be the best, you gotta win, you know. He was just, go out there and do your best. And I did well. I mean, my first competition, I broke a record for the teenage division. At 14 years old, I bench pressed 100 pounds. He showed me in the record book that the old record was 75 pounds. I'm like, I beat it by 25 pounds. Another thing that I would do with my dad was helping restore cars. I really like classic cars. Throughout high school, I drove a 1965 Oldsmobile. The reason the car was so precious to me is because I helped with it. We got in the trunk, you know, scraped out the rust and painted the primer on there and put in the carpet. My dream car is a 1967 Chevelle Supersport. My parents had one. I remember my dad had a, you know, the 396 in it with the big fat tires on back. And we had a school field trip. Here's my mom bringing me to school in the hot rod. I get out like I'm all cool, and like, and all he's like, wow, look at that car. At that moment, I'm like, the Chevelle, that's my car. So someday, I hope to get myself a 1967 Chevelle. When I was working at Subway as a sandwich artist, there was someone who came in who was at a wrestling school, and they were just talking to me about it, and I really didn't know that women wrestled. So when he invited me to the school to be a participant, I was thinking mud wrestling. I don't think I fit into any of this. I guess I'll go down there and just check it out. My very first wrestling match was in Land O'Lakes, Florida. It had been raining all day long. I was outside, and they had this big show planned. No one showed up, pretty much. So the rain did stop. They tried to mop up the ring as best they could. There was a pickup truck with the door open, and I stood behind the pickup truck. You know, there's like the window. I'm like looking through, waiting, looking at the ring, and I'm hiding behind it, kind of trying to warm up. And they said, and from Minneapolis, Minnesota, Starla Saxton. And my vision was that there's gonna be these thousands of fans. I'm gonna be tossing my confetti stars to everyone, and they're gonna be reaching, oh, Starla. Well, I run out there, and there's like six people spread out around the first row of the ring. So I'm running up and handing them little stars, still getting in the ring, waving to pretty much no one. I did get enough experience to have a tryout match for WCW. Dean Malenko was there, and he watched my match. After the match, he said, why don't you come down to my school? I'll help you out. So I trained with Dean for a while, and I still wrestled locally in Florida. Macho Man Randy Savage was looking for someone to train his girlfriend so that she could learn how to wrestle. For about a month, I trained with his girlfriend, and we all became friends, and he said, how would you like to come on television with us, be part of my entourage in World Championship Wrestling? And I was like, man, I was so shocked that he'd want me to be part of his thing, and happy, and oh, it was definitely a dream come true.
Speaking of distractions, they're in the ring, Paintbrush City. Do it! Do it! Do it! Please do it! Oh, did he ever! Talk about being introduced. Doesn't look like there's a whole lot of ring
Medusa.
Rust.
Medusa, be madness.
They
now get the hell out of the ring so I can win the title.
They got in the ring.
Well, listen, look at these two. They're getting into an argument on the side of the ring.
Oh, my.
They're blaming each other.
Oh, yeah!
We've got a fight! Tear it up, girlfriend! Tear it up, girlfriend!
My parents are very happy for me. They worry sometimes that I might get hurt, but my mom especially is just thrilled that I'm doing this for a living because she gets so excited that I get to go to all these fun places. I mean, I've been to Tokyo and of course getting to come to the Bahamas. I send her pictures and she's just happy that I get to see the world and do all these fun things because not everyone gets to enjoy their job, and I love mine.